here we are at 104 Hill Road. Only two houses on this road. The other one's a farmhouse about a quarter of a mile down that way. Mostly farmland, trees, hills, open space. And here's the house where I grew up. My parents built this house when I was 5 years old. We put that tree in some years later. It was only about 6 feet tall, I think. Still on well water here. No city water. We put that pump in for Dad. That's something he wanted just in case we lost electricity. We had a little triangle out there with the plants. That stop sign intersects with Hillsdale Road. We had wisteria on either side of the driveway, which they paved for us after Dad passed away. It was very nice of them. Mom had different plants out here in her flower beds all the time. These shrubs obviously have been there for a while. But she used to plant different things. The house used to be a light blue with black shutters. That's Mom and Dad's room there. There used to be a pear tree here, which now seems to be a nesting place for a plastic rabbit. Yeah, we did the roof and everything there. That's funny. Now, along here on the west side of the house, there used to be more trees. Our neighbor went through and cleaned it out, all the ugly ones for us. There used to be vines growing off the trees and things. I used to swing on the vines. I remember one broke while I was about mid-swing. I came down pretty hard on my back and lost my breath. Now Debbie's planting something there. This is a close-up view of the side of the house. The addition we put on the back. It's a little retaining wall with stone down there at your feet. In the way backyard, we put in a sand mound when we built the addition. In the shed back there that Grandpa and Dad built years ago. The pool looks a bit different because they have a new deck and new sides on the pool, new liner and everything. Apparently it crashed and flooded the basement. We kept our picnic table over here, and the grill and other things like that used to eat out there. There were little paths up and down the tree row for small animals and things, and we used to play back there. The neighboring field sometimes had corn, sometimes soybean. That was the cover for the filter, pool filter. Now on the way back there in the trees, we had that spot cleared off, and it was Dad's hope to build a patio area back there with a stone grill for making food and stuff that was in the shade. Here's a better view of the shed, which we did put the new siding on when we did the addition. I had some trees here on the side of the shed. I used to climb up the trees and then hop on top of the shed. Tried jumping off a couple times, but it just tends to sting your feet. Here's a better view of the back of the house. Now what's really nice is, after Dad passed away and they were doing things to the house, they put these double doors on the back of his garage area there, the shop. That was really nice of them to do. And the yard isn't a swamp anymore. I'm walking on solid ground. Now these two fireball bushes turn a brilliant bright red in the autumn. They're just absolutely gorgeous. Start off pretty small. You know, maybe knee height. Now that window there on the bottom, that used to be my room. They had the basement reparged on the outside. Debbie's got those seats out there, which I assume somebody uses from time to time. Little propane tanks there because the stove was still a gas stove. And let's go in. So here's the homestead. The living room here with the ceiling fan. The curtains are different, but the whole scheme that they're doing in here is more of a red and neutral with some rustic woods. It looks really good. We had green carpet in here and brown carpet. Now it's to a neutral color. This is Grandma's old piano, which was perpetually out of tune. They got some pictures of all of us kids at the top. There's that handsome couple over there on the left. We got married in October of 1999. And then Joe and Aubrey got married in August of 2007. Ben and Jerusha got married in May of 2007. And then our ringleader, Debbie, she was the oldest of us. She's not married yet, but that was her high school photo. They did this nice decor on the red wall there. I think that looks kind of sharp. Into the dining area there. That table I remember driving to pick up. The walls in here are a sponging that Debbie did years ago with a muted blue and tan on a white base. This room used to be my room when we first moved in. It used to be all blue, and then Debbie had to take it over when we started to outnumber her boys to girls. Dad built this shelf that goes around three different walls, and Debbie has just oodles and oodles of memories and keepsakes on top of there, just completely decorated to the nines. She can tell you what every single one is and where she got it. She's been doing all kinds of crafts and different decor things of her own. That vanity came from somebody, I think, in the family. It has a mirror, but it's not attached at the moment. She painted flowers on the walls. She actually had me paint some of them too. This was the first one I did, and it was a daisy, which you can't see very well. Let me see if I can fix that for you. There we go. So I painted the daisy, and then Debbie painted the greenery and the leaf there. And backing up here, we've got some other flowers that she did on the wall there, different kinds of flowers and different greenery. I think there was a wall hanging there. She used to have a parakeet in this room, named Budgie. Here's our bathroom, our first and only bathroom for a long time. It's undergone some changes, some vanity, the mirrors there, the shelves, the wallpaper. We put an overhang in there to accommodate ductwork with the air conditioning. Debbie's gone with cats. That's interesting. If you want a funny story, ask Lisa about that ring. The hamper is down here. It used to be a hamper, then Dad put in a chute. It goes downstairs to the laundry. I always wanted to work up the nerve to go down there like a slide, but he convinced me that was not a good idea. This was not the original shower and bathtub. The original one got busted when Joe accidentally fell and put his elbow through the bottom. So Dad and I cut a hole in the wall and slid a one-piece unit in from the kitchen. So that was very nice to have that one piece. Now, turning around here, across the hall is Mom and Dad's room. Mom and Dad's room undergone changes as well. Used to have that ugly brown carpet. Used to be blue, and then they went with a different kind of greenish thing with the border. A lot of things changed in the house, of course, in terms of decor. This hasn't changed. That was Dad's bookshelf. And that was Dad's light. He used to, on a Saturday morning, he used to try to read or try to sleep, and we'd come in and ransack the bed, and he'd start a tickle war, or we'd start the war. I'm not sure exactly who started it. Here was his dresser, and his space there on the top. That was always right there. Mom's was across the room. Used to have spider plants hanging in there. Now, out here in the hallway, this was our one hallway closet. So this was for linens and stuff like that. And I remember at the very top shelf, Dad used to keep his electric trimmers, which I thought was really cool, and I always wanted to play with them, but, you know, not allowed. Now, going into this room, this was Debbie's room when we first moved in, and then as the boys grew numerous, Ben and I took this room with bunk beds. And then when everybody moved out, it became the bird room with all the various bird decor, the computer, the desk, things like that, just lots of stuff, the couch. I think Grandma was sleeping in here before we put the addition on. Yep, games, love games. Now here was the addition itself that we put on from start to finish, and it looks rather seamless, which is rather nice. That was a big closet, just for Grandma. Now across the hall here, there's a linen closet. What's neat about this linen closet is it opens from both sides, so it actually opens into the bathroom on the other side so you can get to your stuff easy. We had vaulted ceilings in the room here, and did sort of like a very, very pale pink on the walls, and then Debbie got some stencils, some of her own stencils, and she put those roses above the windows, which look really, really cute. Now the bathroom, Dad did all this tiling in the bathtub himself. I remember laying down the cement for the floors and making it all just right, but I do not envy him for putting all those tiles in. He made it a double-sided shower, so they got the head on the back, and over to the right is the main head, which is on a slider. You can make it higher or lower, depending on your height. Single sink vanity and medicine cabinet window there, window going out. Going back into the main center of the building. Oh, you like that hole? That was a yardstick I threw at the door. I was trying to hit Debbie. This was a table, I remember when we got that. This hutch we've had forever. It had dishes and just pictures of family just loaded into it. Those cupboards used to be a medium to dark wood. Now, Debbie got a hold of them and repainted them with this blue and this antique distressing. That's not wood grain. She actually painted that by hand. And then just tried to do some other decor. She did some really interesting things with berries and vines. That turned out to be very nice. That's the original brick backing that's been there since they had the house. Mom used to be able to see out the back and make sure that we were behaving in the pool, because, you know, kids don't. Obviously the fridge is new. This stove, Dad and I got up at 4 in the morning and installed that on Christmas morning so we could surprise Mom. It actually worked, too. Another thing, Dad got a dishwasher for Mom, too, a separate time. He used to get that stuff through his company. Really, really worked out well. That mixer has been there forever. And there's the back door leading out to the driveway. Now, going downstairs, if we go downstairs, first thing we'll do is turn left. This was our music slash office room area. Computer was down here. Well, was. It's now the entertainment center of some sort. So they watch their movies down here where it's cooler. Let's see. We framed up the wall there and put insulation to kind of keep it nicer in the wintertime, and it worked out really well. Look at this. This is hand-carved. It was an ox cart pulling wood. That was the whole idea. Dad loved models. He used to make them all the time. He made models for aircraft and planes, cars. He had a tractor trailer. It was awesome. That paralamb bruised my shoulder. It was so heavy when I helped Dad carry it down that it actually hurt. Now this you've got to see. This is Big Bertha. When my dad was the principal of a private school, he had a bunch of teenagers that thought they were above the law, so he made Big Bertha. They never actually had to use it, but I think they got the point. We used to use it as a picnic table when we were younger because it was big enough. Now, we still have a lot of storage in the basement, or did, when I took this video. It's much more organized than it used to be. I know that Joe said he was interested in some of these musical instruments that are on top. I don't know if that's still going to happen. I kind of hope it does. Now, straight back is the shelves that Dad and Grandpa made. They're pretty big, Grandpa Gill. When they built Dad's shop, they went ahead and put shelves on the outside because they figured we could use them. There's still plastic on the walls just to protect from moisture. Sorry, I'm not trying to make you dizzy. Now to the right over here, we have the air handling unit. Now Dad, I think, installed that entirely by himself. I helped him with some of the duct work and some of the tubes, but he installed the whole unit by himself. Now what used to be Dad's shop then became Ben and Joe's room. And with Ben and Joe having been married and moved out, it's no longer that. But you can tell, I mean, this huge, huge cabinets hanging up on the wall. The black light, you know, that was my contribution. Turn that space into hanging space, closet space, lots of toys, lots of books. That used to be a big door, and Dad turned it into his workbench. Did a lot of work in this room. Used to have the shopsmith and everything. Now in the corner here, he made these shelves. If you remember tin coffee cans, we used to use those for screws and nails, bolts, things like that. Ah, the upright position, the treadmill in the upright position. We used to watch movies or play video games down here. Some artwork, some rubber band cars, a little bit of lumber up top that, you know, nowhere else to store it. That's my boys' rooms. Got milk? Now here is the laundry room. Nothing fancy, of course. You know, it was just outside Dad's shop. We had the wall completed so that we wouldn't get any dust. I think those are newer since I was there. Air handling, going out to the shop so it wouldn't freeze in the wintertime and wouldn't bake in the summertime. Oh, the chute upstairs in that one bathroom. This is where it comes out, so obviously you go flying down that thing, there's not much to break your fall other than a basket and a concrete floor. Which is why Dad told me not to do it. It just wouldn't be a good idea. Anyway, it looked like Dad started framing in here. There is actually plumbing in the concrete floor, so there's supposed to be the ability to put a bathroom right here. But it looks like he just got a little busy and couldn't finish. I mean, it happens. So we keep pool chemicals and other toys and things like that. I'll apologize now for the state of my room. I probably shouldn't have put the ugly side of the door out, but no. That was just my own stupidity. This was my room. I had those squares on the wall and bricks. I did all those bricks by hand. That was not easy to do. Got some floral foam and cut it. Each of the squares, I intended to fill up the whole wall with different designs. You know, the piano bar across there, which I think has too many keys, if I remember correctly. My 20th birthday, I filled that out and people came in and signed it for me. It was a lot of fun. Just different stuff. The fly strip paper, which turned out pretty good. I didn't put the flies on, Joe did. I liked tiger stripes. That was just an experiment with color. Mega Man characters. Some little teddy bear that I never really did much with, but I thought it was really cool at the time. Yeah, Joe kind of absorbed my room after I got married and left, which was fine with me. I didn't mind. No use to let it sit around. Let's see, what else have we got over here? Aha! Batman. And Metal Storm. I forget what that thing's called, but that's a really cool machine. This is some of the stuff Joe did, his characters. Funky Winkerbean, I think his name was. No, Funky Winkerbean, never mind. Sparky Thinkernut. That's what it was. Jeremy Hall did some drawings. I did some drawings of my own. My cousin Jake, whose wedding I was up for. Ben did some drawings. Joe did some drawings. Now, Debbie commandeered my closet, so this is a cacophony of different imagery. Different movies that she liked. Some movies that I've never seen. This kid. Oh, gosh. Some caption about the thermometer and where you put the thermometer or something like that. Far Side cartoons. Here was interesting. This closet is all under the staircase. And so are these drawers. When Dad and I were building my room, I asked him if it would be possible to put drawers under the stairs because there's not a whole lot of floor space in this room and I was afraid I'd run out. And it worked. So I hung the phone here, put a phone booth around it. Anyway, that's my lovely room. The silver door. See, the silver side should have gone out, but you know, that was just my own stupidity. Anyway, going out. Out the back here. I wanted to show you my dad's shop. Obviously a lot of stuff going on in here. It was tough. It was tough coming in here and looking around, but a lot of great memories. Bill Sprague bought the Shopsmith, so we were really excited about that, and he was very kind about it, making sure that none of the boys wanted it first. When the time comes, I'll probably buy it back from him if I've got the room. But Dad drew up all these plans. He had plumbing in here. He eventually, I think, hoped to put a toilet, so he used that otherwise. The rafters, we had to put this steel beam in place, which was not necessarily easy, but we're glad we did it because it's a pretty big span. Pool filter goes there. Obviously, there's little hoses and whatnot. Oh, these trees back here. I gotta show you. There's this giant oak tree back here that I always wanted to climb and I never got around to it. Now I guess I won't get a chance. I would have had to throw a rope with a rock or something over a branch so I could get up there, but oh well. I have other things to do. But that was our home.